What is up, my original bagels, and welcome to some Call of Duty Modern Warfare gameplay. So today, guys, I want to talk to you all about is the next Call of Duty game, COD 2020. We actually don't know the name or anything as of now, but we can speculate that it is going to be Cold War / Vietnam War. Now, we don't know what it's really going to be called, if it's going to be a reboot of the Black Ops series, just like they did with the Modern Warfare series. We could easily see that, but yeah. Let's just get straight into it, guys. So we are now, or have been, in the month of May, and we've only seen one Activision game revealed for 2020. And of course, usually around the end of May, we will start seeing a teaser trailer or even a little reveal of what the next Call of Duty game would be or what the title of it will be or something like that. And with the Summer Game Fest going on right now, with its Phase 1 lineup having the likes of 2K, Activision, EA, and many more, with Activision being in this phase, and we actually got some PS5 gameplay, which I actually uploaded to my channel yesterday, and a big rumor going around is either today, the 14th of May, or tomorrow, the 15th of May, we could see a big reveal for the next COD game. Now, this hasn't been confirmed or anything, so we don't actually know if this is actually happening then or not. Now, Treyarch Studios put out a tweet about new weapon bribes for free. It's like pick a weapon bribe or something like that, and then half off as well. Now, this also ends May 14th, of course, as well as the creators of probably one of the worst Call of Duty games, Sledgehammer Games, actually tweeted out that they have double XP as well until the 14th of May. Now, this is leading some people to speculate, well, if both of these end on today, then maybe we could see something tonight happening, or even tomorrow, about the next Call of Duty game. Now, is this a coincidence? I think not. Hotel Trivago. Now, it could literally just mean nothing. However, David Vonderhaar, so for whoever, everyone in the COD community should really know who David Vonderhaar is. If you don't, you've been living under a rock and you're just uncultured. He actually blacked out his Twitter. He's also done this when they were revealing Black Ops 3 as well. And he deleted all his tweets. Now, this could literally just mean nothing. However, other Treyarch people have actually been doing this as well. So this could mean that the next COD game will probably be a Black Ops game, or kind of like a Black Ops spin-off kind of game. Now, this could be our first clue to having what the next COD game is. More likely, if this is happening, I could see it then being like maybe a Black Ops game. Me personally, I think it will be. Now, lots of things that Activision have are actually ending today or tomorrow, and now one of the games for Activision that was revealed at the Summer Game Fest was remastered Tony Hawk 1 and Tony Hawk 2 Pro Skater, which is good. Now people have been putting together some casework or detective work, if you'd like to call it that, with May 14th, 1955, the Cold War actually deepened then, with treaties signed. So we'll have to wait and see if something actually does happen today, or it could even be tomorrow maybe. If it is Black Ops or kind of a Cold, it is going to be a Cold War game, of course. I'll be doing videos on what characters we could see. For example, we could see Mason coming back, we could see Hudson from the CIA, we could see Woods, any number of those. Also could see numerous guns like the Galil, maybe the MSMC, but even though that was from Black Ops 2, but you never really know what they could do. And attachments and all that kind of things that could be in the game, you never really know. And of course, we're still speculating at this time, but really and truly, for me personally, because Treyarch are coming and kind of picking up the mess that Sledgehammer and Raven Software created, I could see it being a kind of a big Black Ops game, and this kind of, they could easily use stuff that they had from Black Ops 4 or Black Ops 5 from it, or even Black Ops 1 kind of things, because I know I said in previous video they could easily use stuff that was in the Black Ops 1 game that they didn't use the script and actually put into this game, which would be kind of cool. It would show kind of other stuff, but I still think that it would have been a better idea to have Modern Warfare 2 remaster come out now. Well, not now, but for COD 2020. And because of everything that is actually happening in the world, or even just release multiplayer then and just add a good bit of stuff from the old Modern Warfare games into that. And, you know, it would have been a good idea to do. And people would have been like, yuck, fair enough, you can't really do much or do anything now because of everything that's happening in the world right now. But you never really know. For me personally, because Treyarch are coming in, I think it's going to be a Black Ops game. Maybe a spin-off, it may be even the foundation to another Black Ops game. This could be the soft reboot of Black Ops all over again, and we could have Woods in it, we could have Mace, and we could even have another person. We could have different people in it, you never really know. But as of now, Woods has not been contacted. The voice actor has not been contacted. So that could easily change in a while. You never really know, because getting voice actors in, it doesn't take that long to do the voice acting, to be honest. But, you know, I think personally it'll be a Black Ops 1 if Treyarch and everything are blacking out their Twitter and everything like that. So you never really know, to be honest. But me personally, I would say that it is. And yeah, this is the end of the video, guys. I hope you did like it. If you did, please hit the like button and hit the subscribe button right beside the like button. Right beside the subscribe button, there should be a notification bell to stay up to date whenever I upload to the channel. I'm going to try and upload more content, from Call of Duty to Rainbow to any other games that I have or that I be getting, or even highlights of live streams. And speaking of live streams, I actually have a live stream that I try to live stream every week on. That will be down in the link in the description below. Once you are there, you can hit the follow button and you can hit the notification bell to stay up to date whenever I go live there. I play numerous games like COD, Minecraft, maybe even CSGO, Valorant, and other games and everything like that. I'm also close to unlocking drops for Valorant, so if you want to go down into the link in the description below to my Twitch and follow it and just watch me, you will get the Valorant key if you don't have one. I also have a Twitter that I manually update whenever I upload or whenever I go live. Link to that will be in the description below as well. But yeah, that's it, guys. Hope you like, favorite, and subscribe, and peace.